Hello. In this video, we'll see how you can integrate BMC Discovery with One Identity Safeguard for Privileged Passwords. Safeguard for Privileged Passwords is a credential broker software that acts as a vault to store and manage credentials and assets in your IT environment. Your assets include computers, servers, network devices, directories, and applications. This video is applicable for both cloud and on-premises installation of BMC Discovery. Before you proceed, make sure you have installed Safeguard for Privileged Passwords and saved all your assets credentials in the Safeguard Vault, and added the assets in the Safeguard Vault by using the Application to Application option from the Settings, External Integration menu. This integration supports only credentials of type password, SSH key, and private keys. The restriction is due to the limitation imposed by the Safeguard Application to Application REST API. You must perform these three tasks for a functional integration with Safeguard Vault. Integrate BMC Discovery with Safeguard Vault by establishing a connection between them. Create a sample Safeguard credential and test it, and perform a sample discovery scan and verify whether you can discover an endpoint by using the sample credential. Let's start integrating BMC Discovery with Safeguard Vault. From the main menu, click Administration. Then, click Vault Management. Click Safeguard Vault. Initially, the integration does not exist. Select Enabled to enable the integration with Safeguard Vault. In the URL field, enter the URL in the HTTPS format of the server where the Safeguard Vault is installed. Contact your Safeguard Vault administrator to obtain the URL, username, and password to access Safeguard Vault. Enter the Safeguard application name that you had registered earlier in Safeguard for Privileged Passwords. BMC Discovery accesses the Safeguard Vault server by using the TLS Certificate Bundle authentication method. Click Choose File to select the TLS Certificate Bundle file from your system. The certificate must be in PEM format. Consult your Safeguard Vault administrator to get the certificate bundle. If the certificate bundle is encrypted with a passphrase, BMC Discovery requires the passphrase to decrypt and use the bundle at runtime. Select the checkbox and enter the passphrase. If your certificate bundle is not encrypted, skip this field. Checkout duration is the time in minutes for which the password will remain valid. Enter a new value or retain the default value of 15 minutes. A minimum of 1 minute is allowed. The timeout field defines the timeout in seconds for requests sent to the Safeguard Vault server. Enter a new value or retain the default value of 300 seconds. The TLS certificate check option defines whether the system should check the TLS certificate against the Safeguard Vault server. You can clear the checkbox to disable the certificate check, but do so only in a test environment. Let's click Test to confirm if BMC Discovery is connected to the Safeguard Vault server. A successful connection displays the message, Test OK. If you see an error in the status field, recheck the URL and the other field values you entered. Also, verify if the Safeguard server is up and running. Click Apply to save and complete the integration between BMC Discovery and Safeguard Vault. Alternatively, if you have configured BMC Discovery Outpost or have a BMC Helix Discovery installation, you can perform the integration task from the Outpost. Open the Outpost in a separate browser tab. From the Manage menu, click Vault Providers. Click Safeguard Vault and integrate your instance with Safeguard Vault. As demonstrated just now, we've completed the integration task. Let's now move on to creating a sample Safeguard credential. From the Manage menu, click Credentials. Click Add. As a sample, we're adding an SSH credential. Enter a unique label for the credential. From the Vault Source list, select Safeguard Vault. Enter the Safeguard service account name and asset name, as configured in Safeguard. For SSH authentication, select key if the SSH key is configured or select password. Enter the relevant safeguard values. Select the checkbox to permit the password to be sent when a command, such as sudo, requests a privilege escalation. But note that you must not select this checkbox if you have selected the SSH key checkbox because both the authentication methods are mutually exclusive. Click Apply to save the credential. The new credential is available in the Credentials tab. Let's test this credential to ensure that it's valid. To do this, from the Actions menu, click Test. Enter the IP address of the host you want to validate, and click Test. The success message confirms that the sample credential is valid. We've completed the credential test. Let's now move on to the last task of performing a sample scan. From the Manage menu, click Discovery. Click Add New Run to perform a test scan. Enter a label. Select Snapshot. And enter the IP address of the host you want to discover. Click OK. The snapshot scan runs immediately. After the scan is complete, go to the Discovery Access page. You can see that BMC Discovery has succeeded in finding the endpoint by using the sample safeguard credential. We've now completed a successful scan of an endpoint by using the sample safeguard credential. Credential brokers are designed with human interaction in mind. BMC Discovery can make many simultaneous API calls when it scans your IT environment. Before you put the integration with a supported credential broker into production, we recommend that you conduct scale and performance testing in your IT environment. For more information about this topic, see the BMC Online Documentation Portal. Thanks for watching.